Dr. Beck, Functional Medicine Channel. And so today's topic is, of course, a major topic of everybody's attention these days. And the topic is just information here. I'm just sharing information. I'm not taking a stand. I'm not an anti-vaxxer. I'm not telling you what to do. I'm just sharing information. Now, I do this often. I've just done nutrition, on breathing, etc. This is a specific topic that I want to share with you that I'm inundated with. I have people calling me and WhatsApping me and emailing me from all over the world. What should I do? Should I take this? So I feel very important that at least I want to share some information with you. I want you to respond and comment here on the channel, on my Facebook page. This is a community and we're building a community. So what I want to share with you is a couple of things. Everybody's asking, of course, is the vaccine safe? So they're asking leading community leaders and religious leaders. And if somebody says the vaccine is safe, then they haven't done their homework and they're not giving you honest truth information. One of the things part of my channel is that there's truth and falsehood. And the whole world is based on everything we could think about is truth and falsehood. Like the most false thing on the world might be Coca-Cola. It might be something like this as well, and I'm just sharing that information with you. So is the vaccine safe? So the CDC, the Center of Disease Control, noted and reported and published that out of 112,800 people, 3,000 approximately had a health event. Now that health event means that the person was weakened to the point where they couldn't function in daily activities, they couldn't go to work, and they needed medical help. So that's about 3%. Now if we look, for instance, in this country so far, in the country of Israel, these are the numbers that I just took down off the internet. So out of about 490,000 people who were tested positive, unfortunately and tragically, about 3,600 passed away, which is less than 1%. Just to keep things in perspective, in the year 2018, a couple of years ago, there were about 2,400 people passed away from influenza flu. So we've been talking about what COVID is, what kind of virus is it, compared to the flu, etc. Remember, everybody's talking about a novel virus. And no matter who you are and which camp, it's called a novel virus because this is not a naturally occurring virus like the flu or influenza, which has been around for X amount of hundreds and maybe thousands of years. Novel meaning this was created by a research project in the laboratory. It's called gain of function research. And this is all published in peer review magazines, so in publications like Nature. So the FDA has a safety surveillance list of possible side effects or outcomes of the vaccine. Now, so they include paralysis and autoimmune. Now, when I spoke about autoimmune, I wanted to stress that because this is the first time in history that there's such a thing as called messenger RNA vaccine, which creates in the cell actually an autoimmune response. Now, when they say, is it safe now, and they will give a prediction of the amount of side effect of getting the injection, let's say there'll be swelling in the arm or there might be a fever for a couple of days. Well, that's what's happening now. Nobody knows what's happening from 10, 20 years from now. And so we could project that based on other vaccines, like the use of aluminum as an adjuvant, which could be causing Alzheimer's, where Alzheimer's patients are noted to have aluminum in the brain. And why would that be? Even though there are no adjuvants in this, and that's why you need a second dose and maybe a third and fourth dose, nobody knows, but the way of which the messenger RNA gets into the cell and creates then a spike protein, which creates an autoimmune response, nobody knows what that's going to be causing in the future. So just to say that this is a safe vaccine is not the case. Now, hopefully in most people it will be fine, and we just don't know. Now, we heard stories about Bell's palsy already, which it could be a small percentage, but Bell's palsy is a paralysis of half the face. We've heard of people passing away, and recently there was a Dr. Michael, a Florida doctor who took the vaccine, and he was an otherwise healthy 56-year-old gentleman who was a pro-vaxxer, and he developed thrombocytopenia, which I didn't write here, it's such a long word to write, and he passed away. So there are cases of people who get sick or pass away from the vaccine, even otherwise healthy people. You've seen that on YouTube, you've seen that around, like the nurse who fainted online. While she was on television, she was on live TV and she fainted. Well, nobody knows where she is now, but the obituary in her town seemed to say that she was buried. So, now, on the other hand, what I want to share with you is it's an amazing thing. Early on in COVID-19 pandemic, we heard about the use of hydroxychloroquine. But of late, in over 20 countries and over 2,000 medical doctors, and what some of the doctors are calling for are double-blind, randomized trials to see if something called ivermectin is a positive way to prevent and treat COVID-19. Now, the way I look at health and my experience in 40 years of being a doctor is you help people. If something works, you help them. If it's non-toxic and you don't hurt them, that's the Hippocratic Oath. You don't wait for clinical trials to start having this available to the population when it could help people and save lives right now. And that's what's happening in the world today. If you follow the money trail, there's the fellow named Anthony Fauci, who's the National Institute Allergy and Infectious Disease Director, and his wife, Christine Fauci, who's the head of the Department of Bioethics at the NIH. Believe it or not, these two top people in the United States have part of the patent of the Pfizer and Moderna vaccine, of this messenger RNA. Not only that, there are people on their staff and themselves who on their staff, because they can't show it directly, that are making royalties from all these vaccines. So when our wonderful Prime Minister is spending billions of dollars on getting this vaccine to everybody, at the same time, this is the most important thing to realize, there is a medicine called ivermectin. Now, what's it made of? One of my patients asked me. It's a soil-based product from Japan. That means it grows in the soil. We might say that in every disease, God created the healing, the antidote before the disease. Well, this is one of them. Soil-based organism, the safest medication maybe on earth of all pharmaceuticals, FDA approved, been used for some years. In 2015, the Nobel Prize for Medicine was received because of ivermectin reversing diseases like river blindness from parasites in Africa. But it is used now in all these countries, Argentina, France, with randomized controlled studies. 1,300 patients in the Dominican Republic, where there are three hospitals and several clinics who all use ivermectin for COVID-19 patients with a 99% cure rate. Now, why aren't you being told about ivermectin? Because it costs $2 a dose and there's no money to be made, where Pfizer is making trillions of dollars and et cetera off this vaccine. So it's important to know the truth versus the falsehood of the world. And again, I'm not taking a stance whether you should get vaccinated or not. I'm just providing you the information to understand what's going on now. And so please, to continue to get this information, to share our thoughts, to share this with other people, please subscribe. Let me know that you're communicating with me on my Facebook page, and I look forward to sharing information with you in the next video. Thank you very much.